Friday night in Glendale, Golda Barton called police to help her with her son.
It was less than 5 minutes. How could it have escalated in less than 5 minutes? He was running away. He was running away.
Barton says her 13-year-old son, Linden, was running from police because he was scared. He didn't want to be taken to the hospital. Linden has autism and Asperger's and was extremely upset. Barton called the police and asked for a crisis intervention team
that knows how to deal with people with mental health issues, okay? So you call them, and they're supposed to come out and be able to de-escalate a situation using the most minimal force possible.
Telling officers her son needed to be taken to the hospital for treatment.
I said, look, he's unarmed, he doesn't have anything, he just gets mad and he starts yelling and screaming, and he's a kid, he's trying to get attention, he doesn't know how to regulate.
When police arrived, her son ran away. One Salt Lake City police officer fired their weapon.
And I hear, get down on the ground, get down on the ground, get down on the ground, down, 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 down.
Police said they were responding to a juvenile psych episode and had reports that Linden had made threats with a weapon, but haven't yet said if a weapon was recovered at the scene. Barton says he didn't have one.
And I thought my son was dead, and they didn't tell me he wasn't dead, and they wouldn't let me go to the hospital for like a long, long time.
Linden is now awake, but his recovery will be an extremely long one. Barton says she takes solace in the support from her community, but needs answers from police.
Why didn't they tase him? Why didn't they shoot him with a rubber bullet? He's a small child. Why don't you just tackle him? You are big police officers with massive amounts of resources. Come on, give me a break.